Good morning, everyone. Good to see so many people over here. Welcome to this workshop, how to create a functional design for your subsetting and masking templates. I will take you through a piece of work I'm doing every day. When I'm visiting a customer, we decide together what needs to be done. That's what we're going to do today, making a functional design for an implementation for masking or subsetting. First of all, I see a lot of familiar faces in this room. That's very good to see, but for those who do not know who I am, my name is Gerard Knol, and I'm consulting at DATPROF Professional Services. So what I'm doing the whole day? We are busy with drafting project criteria, doing research with our customers for what is the scope of a project, what do we want to realize together. We are working on customer implementations, proof of concepts, new customers, existing customers with a new information system, what needs to be masked or subsetted. We are working on education, train our customers in a correct way of using our products so they can develop their own templates and making the right choice in their templates. And we are reviewing customer masking and subset projects. When a customer has developed a template, they may ask us to review it. Sometimes a customer wants to hear if they are on the right track, they ask for a bit fine-tuning, or they encounter functional issues. We can help them while reviewing the template and advising on possible improvements. Let's see today how it's working with an implementation. We start an implementation with a kickoff. And during a kickoff, we see a lot of enthusiastic people when I'm starting a morning kickoff. And in many cases, a customer has already started with a technical play around with our tooling and they are trying to get familiar with the applications. Last week I was at the customer and we discussed the result of a proof of concept, and one of the attendees made the remark, "It looks very simple, I'm excited to get started." And that's nice to see that the team is looking forward to start with our applications. But we must often get a step on the brakes, and before we really start into the masking meshes or which table can be subsetted, we think about functional questions. Questions such as, what do we do? Who is our client? Which problems do we solve? What are the requirements? What are the deliverables? What needs to be delivered? Which predefined conditions can be named? Description of the project team. The names involved in the project teams. The roles, contract details, We work mostly in multidisciplinary teams, and not all the team members know each other in many circumstances. So it's good to get familiar with each other. We need to acquire technical information, what's relevant, server information, database information, account information, how to log on, etc. And not really important, what must be delivered? What do we need in the end of the project? There are many questions possible that can be asked to find out what's needed to done to satisfy a customer. All these questions, the answers, results in a functional design that serves as a reference in the implementation. It contains the calls that must be archived and when a project is successful. We chose not to make a very formal project plan here. I often work with technicians and they're not very happy with a 15-page project plan or even more. When you have made a functional design, it can be translated into a technical design, in which it's recorded how the functional requirements are implemented. For example, which masking measure fits the best based on the functional requirements to have non-existing ELF-proof IBAN numbers in your test database. The answer can be an IBAN generator from DATPROF. That is the technical answer. When we as team agree with the design, we close the design phase and we're starting with the technical implementation. some background information before we start ourselves to build on functional design. The tooling where we work with is DATPROF Subset and DATPROF Privacy. For anyone who has no experience with our tooling, I try to explain in one sense what you can arrange with our tooling. With DATPROF Subset, you can shrink a database by selecting which data is relevant for your test calls, and all irrelevant data is not included in your database. DATPROF Privacy can determine how your test data is masked so that users work with anonymous data instead of production data. We will start this day with each other and work together to create a functional design. We work in pairs. One has the role of client and the other one has the role of consultant. You will receive one or more papers, one for the client and more for the consultant. So the consultant is my role typically in a project and the client is the customer role. I have the papers over here and I will share them with you. We have two types of papers. Papers for a consultant with a background information, and I have a case, and that's for the client. There's a number on the left on the top of the document, and you see number 1 till 15 on your document, and it's the numbers 1 can work together, the numbers 2 can work together. It's based on the number of your document. That's the person we are working together with. If you have number 2, find number 2. And if we start, raise your hands if you're number 1 and 2, and then we see who are our connectants. We are going to make a functional design. It won't be technical, so everyone can participate. If you're a technical one, or you're a sales guy, or if you're a member of the board, for everyone this is possible. The consultants ask the clients as many questions as possible to determine the scope of the project. As pair, you have two papers, one with the case for the client and one with the relevant input for the consultant. The consultant also receives a template which the answers can be entered. The completed document can serve as a functional design for a privacy or a subset implementation. Ask as many questions as possible to find out the goal and the scope for the project. Before we start, I will give you a sample how it works. As a consultant, you have seen that's a financial application that needs to be masked. And you can ask questions such as which state type of data is recorded in the system. The answer can be addresses. And the consultant can ask more and more questions about the addresses. Are they necessary elsewhere in the chain? Need the chain consistent? Or are there test cases with specific address requirements? As example, you need real addresses. Or are there requirements from security? Well, then I'm ready to start with you. Good to know not all questions can be answered. It is a short case. If there's not no information available, please use your own imaginations. If there are any questions, please ask me. I'm over here and ready to answer your questions. We take 30 minutes for this one. So a quarter before 11, 10:55, I will back to evaluate the results with you. Find your partner for this one and let's start. We're going to move on and see what's the results of the functional design. I see a lot of enthusiastic things about it, where I heard, and I want to share something of the results, what was in it. You can tweak your subset on two ways, tweaking your subset on the size or the duration of the project. In this case, when you're optimizing a subset, you need to determine where your focus lies. You want to find out early in the functional design where your, what your goal is to make the subset as small as possible for the size on disk. or the subset, you want to tweak it on the lead time, duration of the subset. If it's important that you can quickly perform a subset, that means a concession for the size on the disk of your subset. Subset first and then anonymize. When you do a project with both subsetting and masking, you will reach in the functional design what's the best order of execution. Do you want to first make a subset or do you want to first make the masking? In this case, we've seen with each other that we have a lot of old customers inside. That's noticed in the case. And I think it's a good idea to first doing a subset and leave all irrelevant data behind and then mask your subset. Multiple types of data available. We see in this case that we have business data and customer data. The business data was not relevant for masking. We can read that in the case. And so you don't have to mask it all. And that was one thing you can see in this case. From the GDPR, you must mask personal data, and business data is not always required. Thank you for joining this workshop. Next workshop is from my colleague, Carrie Leeds. Thank you.